Hello everybody, and
Yeah.
welcome to episode 2 of Dota with Dan.
This should be
Thought.
interesting.
This is gonna be the second game I'm playing, as you can tell by episode 2, and I'm gonna be going into the safe lane this time, rather than dual off lane with techies. And I'm gonna be playing Juggernaut, if you haven't already noticed, which is gonna be fun. It's gonna be pretty fun. Anyway, so this game, I think, since I'm playing solo, unlike last game, I'm going to be focusing a lot more on what I'm doing and why I'm doing it.
To battle.
This will be, I don't know, for your entertainment, but it'll also be for me improving the player, which is definitely something that I want to do. Yeah,
so can you prevent him to take it?
So right now, I'm just
because he's going to steal it
yet. Rune. I know Treant's top,
battle will commence in
so that's fine.
Seconds.
If you get dust, you will die.
But with that, I'm able to tell that I do actually need to pressure.
Very nice.
Or need to spam.
You
die
MVP.
Very nice.
Also good with that.
Hold on.
So, that CM just warded up there. The game gets pretty blank from this point onwards. But I'm going to be rushing into Quelling Blade. Not because of the changes to Quelling Blade, because it actually got weaker.
That's retarded.
But
you thought the same.
That's a nice start, guys. Three runes and a first blood.
Okay, relax.
Is because of the changes to Iron Branch. No, not Iron
Branch.
Let's
make sure
Iron
to get
Talon.
The last blood, too.
Or, not the changes to Iron Talon. The change in situational need for Iron Talon. Because of the new meta. Well, not the new meta. Because of 7.00, the game is shifting away from AFK farming with the changes to jungle
or
objective based gaming.
This fucking trend
which is something
be
I don't really want to be doing, but I guess I should. And something that farms up my speeds up my farm. Speeds up my farm.
You should buy Sentry Disruptor. We have the PC
and Pudge to stop me from getting that last
hit.
I'm gonna the point here is to allow them to get their last hit, but just to get
so
one.
Just be annoying with a stupid stun all the time.
So I'm gonna just keep
okay,
battling this 1-1.
Last
hopefully
it.
CM doesn't die.
Just last hit.
Okay, he's getting I think he wants a Ricky to last hit. I'm not sure if that's the CM talking to me. I wasn't paying attention. But anyway.
It's an honor.
Monkey's got 3 stacks for me, I'm gonna have to stay back for a minute. That would be a good time to just pop a clarity. No, not clarity. To use a tango so that I can go in a minute. Hopefully he needs one more hit, yeah.
You are mine.
That was a misplay. Just through the use of my thing. When I get level 3, I'm gonna be trying to go on all these guys. I'm gonna ping CM and try and beat this guy in the right click jewels. Oh, crit, man. Anyway, so this should take 2 power hits. Nope, because he drew that range creep aggro, but I still missed it. Great. Should be getting it. But I am not. Anyway, now I've got level 3, I'm going to be able to go. Let's go, Monkey. You can get round out of vision.
Right. Okay, okay.
He'll push the lane. Wait for him to go for the range creep.
Illusion!
Go, go, go.
You can actually get the wrong ones.
We can go on this guy instead. Okay, so this Pudge kill should be pretty simple. Nope, nope, apparently it's not.
Oh, that shit!
And I
just
cannot
get out,
face
man.
This guy.
He has the stupid
yep.
thing shit.
So yeah, that was a very bad situation because we allowed him to get what he wanted, which was the needed
come take a tango
of the necessary amount of hits to proc his passive, which he may or may not be maxing. I think he's only
Treant was right there
now. I'm not sure if he's level 2.
Run if you can.
Pudge is mid, you can see that from the minimap, but now it's really difficult to lane against this Monkey King. Because I can't actually spin on him when he has any stacks on me, because he'll be able to get 4 hits off before I can actually do anything. And if you see his insane attack, I mean, he got his thing. No! I got blocked by the creep wave. That was definitely bad for me. Okay, so, my items. My aim is for 2 deaths again.
Pudge
is already coming quickly.
Pudge is coming bottom.
That catapult put me off there. It's an honor. Nice. Okay. So now I'm just trying not to die in lane. We can go on Pudge. We can go Pudge. On
it. Treant is here.
Okay,
yeah, there, yep.
Yeah, Disruptor, if you want, you can actually help bottom if they need help, I don't know.
Yeah, we need help.
Just keep killing this draw.
Oh, he almost hit that hook. Very almost hit that hook.
Yeah.
I shouldn't be so.
Come and give you salvage.
Go on him, go on him, go on him.
His observer ward just expired me. So, Ricky, it's safe to come here now.
Okay,
You're charging up now, Jugger, don't get hit.
Yep. Monkey just overextended a lot, leaving a space boost to try and run away and kill the disruptor. May have been able to do, but because of the double damage from the crit from the boundless strike, I think.
Punches me.
But I really need to focus on hero capabilities, right? As well as trying to locate other heroes on the map. Being aware of what's going on around me in order to understand what I can safely and what I can farm safely, basically.
Punch is missing, might still be missing.
I'll get dust next for a train. Our train is top, careful.
Monkey King is definitely not a hero that I have kill potential on solo.
Yes.
But to be honest, I don't really need kill potential when I've got this aura, which is amazing. So I think I'm gonna stack this at 54.
Great gank, and then thank
pull
you.
The wave
you
as
wanna
well.
Use this shrine?
Hopefully
use...
this will work.
I need to
take damage from creeps so that I can actually pull the wave. This one range creep will give me
a platform which will last it.
Yeah, he's just trying to get those small stacks on me right now. But that's what I mean. I'll just
drop
down. Somehow it didn't stack. Oh wait, I'm an idiot. I was looking at the 5 minutes. The 5 minutes.
I'll try to get a TP soon so we can come.
Okay.
Shadow is
so
back mid.
I now have my phase boots, which gives me more kill potential on other heroes. It's good for Jugg because it gives me damage as well as
You might have a ward here.
It gives me damage as well as boost speed, which is great for the spin. I need to. We can go.
Shadows.
No, I don't have V6. Wait, we can go.
No, punch shadow mid.
Just stay out of vision, and then you can go wrap round and then frostbite him. I can spin then Omni. Or Omni then spin. Whichever one's more necessary.
Oh, nice.
Punch illusions.
Triant is coming.
Just get back.
That's for your gear bottom.
He sees me, so.
Careful for the hook.
I have Omni. Do you see the sentry range? I had to predict his movements, but luckily for him, he ran.
Cut some trees here. Cut some trees if you can. Get out.
Nah, that was so bad for me. I should not be doing that. Oh, I expected him to still be on the ground, and I cut the wrong tree. So that allowed me to die and survive. This game is going pretty bad, to be honest. I'm not getting the kills I need, and I'm not getting the farm I need. To compensate for that.
I commit, right?
Not getting the farm I need, not getting the kills I need to compensate for that if I do get the farm I need. I'm going to go and get this bounty rune, and then I'm going to go to lane. Missing out on 2 range creeps isn't great, but hopefully I will be able to get more from the rest of this. SF has a regen rune, that means he should probably be staying mid, since he wants to utilize that. In at this level, people generally don't smoke gank as multiple heroes, so I can be sure.
What's up with Monkey? Does he need to die or something? Or is that thing?
He's bottom, he's bottom. Careful, Jugger. Pudge is there also.
So Pudge is level 5. Can you glimpse?
Hook him back. Glimpsing, yeah.
That is tilting. 2 times now. Anyway, I need to get more of the CS. I know it's not a place not or anything, but it is. Sometimes it involves that last taking your teammates, yes. But it's just a part of the job, really.
Attack.
I'm gonna stack this properly this time. Well, not stack it properly. I'm gonna.
Mid is being pushed.
Punch his top. Or bottom, I mean. Sorry.
So I've got Omni Slash back in 5. And I'm still only level 6. Which is really bad. Considering.
She's behind tower, I think. But maybe you can find her.
No, I just saw her.
Is going in mid.
How long ago? Ah,
shoot. I can jump it.
Now, go.
Right now, I'm just trying to beef myself up a bit. So I'll be able to
well play.
Force the game. Force the issue with the other.
Run if you can.
Force the issue with the other team. Monkey King is currently jumping
careful
around.
He's up there.
Isn't good. He missed his. No, he didn't miss it. He just wanted to get down.
Missing mid.
He's playing this right. Things with Monkey King is that. He can easily kill me, and I can kill
Shadow
him.
Is here, at least illusions. Shadow and illusions top.
If he has any assist, I'm
I just ulted his illusion.
Just can't
actually, two of them is
that much to say.
One of them is the real
one punch member.
Yeah, he's trying to fake the illusion top, so
here
be careful.
Right now, then I get hooked, it's then I'm, then it's over.
They don't even have dust now.
It's actually 4 guys top.
Just tapped out.
Careful. Right.
4 top, okay, so now that means I can pressure the Wraith King.
Nice.
The Shrieker said he was 6k, which I'm not entirely sure about. But I'm just gonna taunt this one.
Ah, he didn't get from my boots, why?
Oh. I can't, so. We're kind of at a stalemate right now.
I bring my blade.
Here's the mana boots.
Nice.
Okay.
I think Treant is fucking around here.
To battle. As you wish.
Okay, just a bit quiet there. So basically, there are 3 who will bot.
Of course.
2 bot, maybe 3.
One word. 8 in 4.
So I'm just gonna regen under my power. I'll take an iron tower.
Yep, train to stop.
But try to find him around this sentry. He'll try to walk around eventually.
I don't know if SF. No, did he hook? No, he hooked the creep. I thought he hooked my healing wall for a second. You've been weird. I just missed that CS because I thought the creep. Oh my gosh. Okay. This is gonna be difficult for me to do for a while. Anyway. So their goal there was to kill me, and that didn't happen. So
it's pretty much a good game.
He's level
6. But you're done. And I can go find him.
I timed the monkey. I expected the monkey king stun. Just I thought it would come a bit later than that. I didn't really expect it to come like that soon. But
no problem. Don't worry.
It's I'm just gonna take this creep and I'm gonna run back because I know that there are people there.
Whoops, Pudge is here! Like, yeah, if they wanna kill me, it's fine. I don't really mind. If they commit 3 heroes to die, to death, fine. Good enough for me.
So now we just get 2 kills and then source that. You'll notice I'm following a guide, which I don't really. I use it because I like this skill, but
just get the towers now, we can focus on getting some towers. You don't have to be scared right now. We have Disruptor, Jugger, Viper, go.
Ever since the pressure of laning got so heavy that healing ward maxing early became so strong. Let's get back. Dropping frames. So now this is when the Iron Talon comes into play. Because I'm able to really efficiently farm a jungle. That creep.
You can take it if you want to. Go take the double damage.
Let's take the shrine.
As it would have if I had not done that. If I had not had an Iron Talon. Which is pretty good, considering all things.
Chucky, you want to join us?
No, I'm fine.
Of course.
Thank you.
Okay, so now we can go back into lane. I feel like there's a Pudge here, but I don't want to. So,
right, because I have no vision.
Can I get some vision of
Pudge,
please?
Yeah, I will kill Shadow Fiendus, alright. He's gonna die.
You should have just taken it right away, Ricky. But nice job.
So I'm gonna try and stand in the middle of the creep, though. So, there's no opportunity. If Pudge is here, he's gonna be coming from the left. That's not Pudge. Dodge this stun. Oh, I had Omni Slash up. That monkey would have been alive. Guys, can I get some vision of bot?
Yeah, sorry, I'll do my job better. Or actually, Disruptor bot them all. Someone's bot.
So I'm just. Right now, all I really need to do is stay alive and keep mine. Because this helm is going to allow me to group a lot stronger, a lot better. Almost missed that glove. They just got double kill, they're just taking me power while we lose bot. Apparently it tells me I can still TP there, but I can't. So I'm going to just carry on farming the jungle for a minute. I'll try and sync that up with the timing of the timing of the rune so that I can take an extra boost from the bounty.
I wanted to freeze him inside your ulti.
Kill this, then get the helm, then. Oh wait, no, I can just spin it.
If you know what I mean.
Because there'll be a new creeper coming soon. This one's almost dead.
Mana, please.
I don't have.
I'm gonna last tip this castle and not spin in the creep wave because I just wanna keep it going. Conserving the mana and all. I can also. Forge us into a push, so saving spin would be useful. Those people had family. This Ricky is definitely good. I'm not doing well as I usually am this game, but hopefully I can shine through in the late game. Three deaths is one more than I usually want, but generally from here on out, I don't die. And that's a 4th Shadowblade and that's a 4th or 3rd. So, I had my helm, and I thought that they'd be trying to defend mid, but apparently not. Or at least trying to react to the fight mid. Or the pickoffs. But I was mistaken. So that was.
Guys, let's come push some towers. We should push right now so we limit.
I've got a helm, so I'm going to come and aid those guys in pushing. And hopefully we'll be able to find a lot more from this. I can TP to the shrine, then I can go and look for a decent creep. Nice, first camp. Beautiful. Alpha Wolves, in case you didn't know.
Oh, for fuck's sake, he's such a lucky bastard.
Bonus. A bonus damage aura, so it gives 30% bonus damage to, I'm pretty sure, all units. Oh wait, get this guy. So that was my micro mistake. Where's my apple? Where did it hit?
Already moving.
I'm getting quite a significant frame rate drop.
To battle.
16 solid frame rate. FPS. May I just walk out of the Monkey King hole? Hopefully rather quickly. Oh, double kill.
Permanently
we can push on for more. Hopefully TM have a frostbite in attacking. Triple kill. Okay, so that really was basically created by the Ricky, but it allowed me to get so much. I've almost got my full Yasha
on it.
And we can transition this into a further push. I also have Omni Slash, level 2 for the first time, which will be able to give more. Paired with the Alpha Wolf. I think it's an Alpha Wolf, yeah.
Nice mid, just push. We got this tower as well.
Yeah. We can. But these towers, just they give so much. Especially with the nerf to the farm and the supplied in the jungles. It's just such a good thing.
He's actually still mid.
He has a Shadow Blade though, so we need detection.
I have detection, I have detection.
Okay, good.
Swiftly now.
Solid 16 FPS, it's really doing well. So, now I've... Now my kill seems to be going well, but generally I want at least 3-1, if not 2-1, at least 2-1, if not 3-1.
Yes.
Ratio on my kills to deaths, because in the safe lane there is a lot of responsibility that's put on your shoulders, and if you're just feeding or just carelessly
dying,
how
do you take the invis one?
It's not good, which is what I'm doing basically, but I'm doing it.
I actually just want a gem.
No wolf, no, 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 I think it's life. Should be fine. We can push into this. I want to save my Omni Slash. And I want to check Drow's items. He doesn't have anything good. Now I can Omni Slash her. Nice. That was a really good fight. And there's still a Pudge here. Let's just push.
I fight.
Oh wait, I still have my Alpha Wolf.
Yeah, push.
I'm under attack. I know.
The Fusil Bladed Ricky is on 20 HP. Nice.
They're all dead.
Just wait around, I'll have a healing one in 10 seconds.
On it.
Yeah, just push the mid tower, guys.
No, 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 Alpha Wolf.
So you say?
Come onto the healing ward.
Nice.
So I don't want this wolf taking the tower, I agree.
Go top, go top.
Yeah. So this team is very good because it's able to. Because the players on it are able to understand the capabilities of just objective based gaming in this patch. It's the biggest patch update. Changed to the way in which Dota is played for a very long while. And I want my wolf.
I don't have my a wolf. Permanent ward here right now, so be careful.
Where's my wolf? Oh no, my wolf died. Oh, such a bad energy. Anyway, let's take shrines.
Okay, go kill the shrine.
If anyone sees like a alpha wolf, then I'll take it.
I bought a gem now. Spread out so that Shadow doesn't have a heyday.
This thing. So, with this, I need my Sash, it's right there. Give the Frost Armor to me. Now I can give Frost Armor to him, and I can see the invisible. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's go take Botchon.
Very well.
The way in which I like to play is generally that of constant engagement. It's sort of
Alpha is right here.
Engagement.
Top,
I'll take thanks, I'll take that in a minute. Let me go get the wolf, then we'll push mid. Or we can, no, we should take Roche because they don't have anywhere to respond. Since we've taken the shrine. If we, as long as we get a ward up on the high ground around there.
Do we have to?
I'm gonna do some high ground checks, but you can start it in the meanwhile.
I'm just gonna get the wolf quickly.
It's an honor.
I'm just speeding it off the road now. Trying to do this as quickly as possible in order to get the most value out of this. Anyway. Roshan's now lost the boss. I'm gonna be dropping my TP for this one. He's not dropping, he's putting my backpack into 7.0. Anyway, I need a
easy guy.
I now have this much for my Manta.
I guess we know who the real monster was.
Okay, so Ricky's reusing the Korea. So I can I'm gonna get my Manta from the secret shop, then I'm gonna come in.
As you wish. Yeah, nice.
As you wish.
So right now we're in a really good position, but we need to be wary. We so need to respect their power and their cooldowns and their abilities.
Yeah, let's push just mid so or bottom then, I think.
Because in this position, quite a few people are generally too optimistic. I mean, we are definitely right here, very maybe? Far ahead. With I'm level 14, but I don't think that's shining ahead, no. I'm a mediocre level 14. What my job in the team fights is to try and distract people, and at this point, survive, and I can siege as well. Just let me stay high ground. Just react if they jump on me. Let's just walk out. Hey, monkey out now. The waste on the slash. I didn't realize Drow had a shadow blade, but I don't know. At this point, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, just get the racks. Good job.
As long as easy, you can overextend, then it's fine. I'm gonna go mid. So I can take my non existent wall with me to kill the cow mid now. Take the melee, then we get back. It's epically up in 10.
We can kill them all, it's so fast.
Nah, we don't want to
we have the general. So.
We can just reset and push again. It's not worth risking it, fighting under that hit force.
Yeah, back now, back now.
Just go take top tower. No.
Oh, we go back. We just try to lure them out and then we...
We shouldn't finish just yet. Already moving. It's a lot easier.
Go back, Ricky. They probably have a jump.
With a siege.
Yeah, we'll get a cache now that they leave the base. No, Disruptor, what's going on?
Yeah, he's just killing them all anyway.
Yeah, I'm just killing Drow now.
About that.
See, no, I didn't. I thought my ulti would kill her.
Yeah, that's what I mean about overextending. So, basically, we can just
go top, go top.
Wait, I'll get my healing ordered up in a second. Is there a catapult? No. Take 2-4 hits. Join that one. Heal myself and my illusions up. Tank the damage. This way, because of the mechanics of Blade Fury, I'm able to yeah, I just got silence, but it doesn't actually stop anything. It just physically moves you, even though it doesn't come.
Try to get out, Jugger.
I've got Aegis.
Yeah, cool.
I can spin TP, I think. Well, I missed time. So,
no, never mind.
What happened there is that the overgrowth managed to come after my spin, which I was trying to dodge the silence, but I miscalculated the cooldown. And that meant that he wasn't able to get off the silence before the overgrowth. So I expected the overgrowth to come out afterwards. I expected the overgrowth to come out around the time of the silence, because it's almost an impossible position if they chain it right. But what I did was I expected them to chain it right, and then they didn't chain it right. So I had an opportunity, but I didn't take it because I was doing that anyway. We are still really far ahead. And the 2-1 KD, 3-1 KDA is shining through now. I have 4k gold, which I've got to spend. I'm going to not buy those items because I don't like them sometimes. A game like this, I don't think they're going to be that useful. Considering we're only 30 minutes in, I might as well get a Vanguard and build that into a Basher in a minute. So, build that into an Abyssal Blade in a minute. And then, I can do stuff with that. Anyway, I'll just go to the secret shop now.
I bring my blade.
DP to the shrine.
Up
like that. Kill the wolf brothers, children, or whatever these guys are. And then we can go and sort out the rest of the game.
Onward.
Finishing off shouldn't really be as that hard. It generally just takes an overextension.
To battle.
Or just, yeah, it's finishing.
Okay, yeah, don't go. I have gem.
I'm gonna take a stun creep. And I'm gonna have to pump. But no, I'm going to send it back, and hopefully they won't kill it in time. Yeah, that's one overextension. Just step outside the ulti, wait it out. About that. Don't get plate.
Don't go in there.
He goes invis. It gives me the shadow beam.
Careful.
Oh,
we need your
heal,
yeah.
Oh, healing ward. Now I can go back in. Seek my destiny. Got one hit off. Monkey King's got his proc. We've taken Rax. We've taken both Rax. And we've won the game. I'm going to now proceed to push. Just cancelling attacks, casually. That's how you play with style. Anyway, so now I can just finish up. It's really simple as well. Take a go to a jug. Patch, you pick a situational fight. This wasn't such a great idea, but this wasn't such a great example of the game. But how I can. How this hero can work, how this hero does work. I want to take this now and get my Abyssal. I'm not gonna get that ammo. I'll get my thing. Salty CM. Usual stuff. Anyway, so that was the second episode of Dota with Dan. This time it was a win. And I guess thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed. Peace out there.